Today's session is about Dora's dream. We are now in the room where probably Dora saw Freud at the time. Meaning, this is the first practice room, probably of Sigmund Freud, because we are now in Berggasse 19, which was Sigmund Freud's apartment and practice, and is now the famous and fabulous Sigmund Freud Museum, Berggasse 19 in the 9th district of Vienna. Newly renovated, and now you can see all the other rooms of Sigmund Freud, all the private rooms as well, and also the first practice room, which is here. What you see here as the couch is of course not the couch. She's first of all not red, and I think not very comfortable either. But she's a work of art. So Dora was born not far from here on November 1st, 1882, in Berggasse 32. This is about Dora's or Ida's second dream. And we are now in the practice and office space of Sigmund Freud, in front of where the couch, the famous red couch, which is in London now, used to be. Also the room where the famous meetings Wednesday evening took place. And we are, of course, at the Sigmund Freud Museum, which is in the rooms of where Freud used to live and work. I was walking about in a town which I did not know. I saw streets and squares which were strange to me. Then I came into a house where I lived, went to my room and found a letter from mother lying there. She wrote, saying that as I had left town without my parents' knowledge, she had not wished to write to me saying that father was ill. Now he's dead, and if you like, you can come. I then went to the station and asked about 100 times, where's the station? I always got the answer, 5 minutes. I then saw a thick wood before me, which I went into. And there I asked the man whom I met. He said to me, 2.5 hours more. He offered to accompany me, but I refused and went alone. I saw the station in front of me and could not reach it. At the same time, I had the usual feeling that one has in dreams when one cannot move forward. Then I was at home. I must have been traveling in the meantime, but I know nothing about that. I walked into the porter's lodge and inquired for our flat. The maidservant opened the door to me and replied that mother and the others were already at the cemetery.